Thanks, Laura. With the 2014 FIFA World Cup quickly approaching, soccer is on the minds of many Americans. One local soccer club with a national championship title is setting the bar high on what it means to be a well-rounded athlete, both on and off the field. Take a look at Lehigh Valley United.
The champions of the U.S. Youth Soccer National Championship U19, Lehigh Valley United 93.
The whistle blew and we were up 1-0. It was truly probably the best time of my life.
Soccer complex, the National Guard.
A 2013 national title.
In the air for Lehigh Valley United 93.
And over 20 state and regional championships to boot. The athletes at the Lehigh Valley United Soccer Club have plenty to celebrate.
That's it, good.
But as I spent the day at their indoor turf club in Allentown, I came to realize these amateur athletes have more on their minds than winning.
We're not just good soccer players, we're also good people.
So just push and then go in another direction. Go ahead.
Greg Ramos, executive director of soccer operations, co-founded the club with his late father, Lou Ramos, in 2007. Greg works hard to develop his athletes both on and off the field.
Character is absolutely a core ingredient to becoming world class. Not only teach technical lessons and skill lessons as they pertain, you know, strictly to soccer, but life lessons and character lessons and things that happen on the field, off the field, are really important.
Teamwork, discipline, and hard work are just a few of the many core values Greg hopes to instill in each of the more than 600 boys and girls that make up Lehigh Valley United.
Because that's been drilled in our heads that we want to be the best we can be. We want to have the best touch we can have. You apply that to other things in your life. You want to be as smart as you can be. You want to study as hard as you can. You want to do the best that you can do for yourself. Get a little space, spread out.
Ryan Brown from Allentown serves as a role model to younger players as part of the club's mentorship program.
It's not the Lionel Messis, the Cristiano Ronaldos, the Abby Wambachs who are the pros on the TV screens. That's when you go to sleep at night and close your eyes. That's when that comes. But really drop players who are 2 or 3 years older. They've been there. They've been to that big event. They've had success. The younger ones want to be like them. And we'll use the older ones to create, in a positive way, a peer pressure to say, you want to be like them, don't you?
Mentors, you grab the white balls.
It gives them something to look up to see, oh, wow, she can do that. Let's see if I can do that.
I got really excited to help the little kids learn how to play soccer.
When I was younger, I always looked up to the older girls because I saw them, like, going off to college and, like, taking soccer so far in life, and I always wanted to do that. So it's really cool to just inspire the younger girls to do that, too.
Inspiring athletes to give back is another goal of the club. They use soccer to reach others in the community and throughout the world with their United Gives Back program.
When one of the team stays overnight in a hotel, they collect the leftover toiletries like toothpaste, soap, and shampoo, and later donate them to those in need.
In 2011, the club raised nearly $12,000 for the Global Association for Vaccinations and Immunizations, also known as the Gavi Alliance.
It feels really, really good, especially inside. I love getting the feeling of helping other people who are less fortunate. But it's not just me, like the whole club, like they all, like they should feel really, really just so happy that they raised all this money.
The lessons that, you know, we want our players and teams to take away, we're trying to, as an organization, as a staff, we're trying to live and breathe those every day.
It's lessons like these that Greg hopes will help his athletes reach closer to their goals. For Focus, I'm Brittany Garzillo reporting.